Hey, what's up everyone? It's me, Ramaf Party, and in this video I will be showing you how to add your own map to Bloons TDX. It is fairly simple compared to other things, but it's still kind of complicated, so pay attention. So yeah, as you can see in Game Maker, you have rooms, and you can edit the rooms, and basically all the maps are separate rooms. So what you're gonna want to do is you're gonna want to go to the blank room, make a copy of it, because the blank room is basically just a canvas for you to sort of just add whatever map you already made. So yeah, you want to go to tile sets and just use the default layer, which is 1,000,000, I believe, something like that, and just go ahead and find whatever background you have. Yeah, like any pre-made background you have will work. Just load it into Game Maker. Each map is about 800 by 480, like 800 pixels wide, 480 pixels in height. And you're also gonna want to set the background to be used as a tile set. That is very important. And then you're just gonna want to put it into the room. Just go to tiles, use the right layer, and then just put the tile in there, or the background, whatever you want to call it. Just put it in there, slide it into position, and yeah, that's about it. You're gonna want it to be the right size though. If it's not the right size, then it kind of just doesn't fit, which is bad. You want it to fit, so make it 800 by 480. Alright, so we got this nice background here going on, and now that you have the map background loaded in, you're gonna wanna now edit the room itself by placing objects. You're gonna wanna select this object called block, and basically the block is where you place the towers, so you're gonna wanna put a block in every single 32 by 32, every single tile basically. Just cover the entire map with those. Alright, once you've covered the entire map up with blocks, you're gonna wanna put in a bunch of path circles in as well. These path circles are very important as well, not as important, but very important, because without them, Spike Factory and other track items won't work as well, so you're gonna need those. Yeah, so just put as many of those as you can along the path. It doesn't have to be neat or precise or anything, but you know, just make them across the track, cover all parts of the track or whatever parts you want it to cover. After that, you know, you want to just move your balloon spawn to wherever it is. Doesn't really matter very much. Also, you're going to want to put your exits down. Your exits should be a bit further along where the actual track exit is, maybe a bit further. You definitely want the exits to be outside of the map screen, otherwise it'll cause some problems. It'll look better if it's outside of the map screen. If you have multiple exits, make sure to put down multiple exit objects down. After that, you're gonna want to put down your balloon, this object called balloon block. You basically put it where the entrances would be. This object is good because it sort of propels the balloons forward and also prevents them from being sent back, because that can cause problems. It's kind of hard to explain why it's necessary, but just make sure to put them down a bit outside of the screen as well. Now up here you have a couple of objects outside of the room. You're going to want to keep those there. Those are important. Those are very important for keeping track of the, like, what level, like what wave you're on, and progress and all that stuff. So basically, after you edit the room, you're gonna have to edit some already existing objects. Alright, so you're gonna wanna make a new controller, basically. And in the new controller, it'll basically be able to keep track of all of the progress for that map, and it'll control a bunch of variables for that map. Basically, you're gonna wanna copy one of the already existing ones, because they already have most of the code written out for you. Just copy one of them and rename it, and set the track to a different value. Currently, the largest track value is 24, so when you're modifying it, you probably want to pick a big number, like bigger than 24, but not that big. So like, we're just gonna give this one a value of 25. That'll work. And then in the step event, change every instance of 22 to 25. Same in the draw event, any 22 you change to 25. Also, there is a difficulty and a bunch of other stuff in here. Basically, that's to keep track of what rewards you get for beating track milestones. That is very important. You want those to make sense in according with the difficulty of the track. Advanced tracks will have different rewards than beginner tracks, so make sure to keep that consistent. And then what you want to do is go back to the room and replace the Monkey Meadow controller with the new controller that you just made. The new track value for the new track. That way it will be able to set up the progress for this new track as opposed to any old tracks. And after that, you're going to want to make a new go-to panel. These are also very important, because without them, you won't be able to even access your track. So I just rename that after your track. And then, like before, change the 22 to 25 for all of these objects, for all of these bits of code. I want to do Control F, find where it says track 22. And change that to track 25. There we go. Wherever it says T22, change that to T25. And you basically just do that. If you have a different number other than 25, you know, change it to that, obviously. But yeah, just do that for this object as well. It's also very important. Then once you've done that, what you're gonna wanna do now is put the track panel in the room with the other track panels. That way you are able to access the track. Just put it somewhere in there. Try to make it consistent. A bunch of these objects are outside of the room, which is somewhat problematic. I may fix this later. In a different open source version, I may make it more cleaner. Instead of just having to manually go into the room and edit them, I might just have a bit of code, just put it in there, and then that would be a lot easier. If that happens, I'd make an update video with the new method for making tracks. But for now, that's how you're gonna have to do it. Just follow exactly what I'm doing on the video. Anyways, after you do that, you're gonna wanna make a new path, which is another thing in Game Maker. You can just make your own paths. So go to the create path button, load up the track, that way you have a reference, and then just start building the track. It's pretty simple to make a track. Just do what I'm doing, make it start like a little further back from the entrance, and then just make it sort of follow along. Just follow along the track, you know, try not to like do any weird janky motions, try to make it follow the path as closely as possible. Then yeah, make it go a little bit further past to where the exit is. If the balloons do not make it to the exit, That would be very bad. So make sure to have the balloons actually reach the exit. And then if you have a track with multiple paths, you're going to want to make another track and name that track similar to the first track, I guess. Now for this track, it's very simple. We just need to mirror the paths. So right here, I'm just going to mirror the path. Make it so that the second path is basically just the first path, but it is flipped over the horizontal axis. And then we're going to shift it a bit, and that should just work. Make sure to actually have the path line up with what the background is. Otherwise, that would just be weird. Yeah, once you do that, you're going to want to go to the script. You're going to want to edit the script. This is the balloon path script. It's very important. Basically tells all the balloons what paths they should take, depending on what the track is. So scroll all the way down. Scroll all the way down. And you're going to want to write a bit of code. This is probably some, here's some actual coding for all of you code people. If global.track equals 25 or whatever track number it is that you're using, if path equals 1, path start, and then just fill it out, write the name of the path that you just created, or one of the paths. And then set 0, 0, 1, which is important. Makes the path like sort of end when it ends and not loop around. Also set move to be equal to path index. It is also important because the balloons have a variable called move that keeps track of what path they are actually taking. And then you're gonna wanna put in the other path. If path equals 1 this time, then you follow the other path if you have more than one track. And then that should be it. That should work. But yeah, once you do that, just try running it. Okay, so one more thing you're going to want to do, you're going to want to find the play bar, which is located in the panel. Wait, is it in panel? No, it is not in panel. Is it in control? Nope. It is in the main menu stuff. Find the play bar and edit the left pressed event. First bit of code here. And under if global dot normal mode select equals 1. Under there, you're going to want to write another bit of code here. If global.track select equals 25, room go to, and then write the name of the room that you just created. And that's about it. Boom, that'll do it. After you do that, you should be good. Just run the game, which will take a very long time unless you have a very powerful computer, because this game is just absurdly long. Luckily, through the power of editing, I just made the process look as if it took 10 seconds, when in reality, it took about 5 minutes and just a blank screen of, like, just, it looked like it crashed, but it didn't, you know? Game Maker does that a lot when you have a game this large. But yeah, just wait a bit more. Here's the start screen for Math Party, splash screen, and boom, here we go. It's the game. Open that up and scroll all the way down, or wherever you put the track go to object, and yeah, click the one that you just made, select normal mode, and go. There it is. Wow, incredible. You can place the towers down. If you did this right, it should work, you know. And here we go, we have a bunch of balloons coming down. They're following the path perfectly, and it's all good. We've done it. We've added a new track. Obviously, there's a bit more. You gotta add 3 separate rooms for the 3 separate modes, and obviously, a couple of other things might be busted. But if that's a problem, just let me know. I'll make another tutorial video if anything was missed in this one. If you need any specific help, just go to Discord. We got a bunch of mod people there that are modding. They know what they're doing, probably. But yeah, that's about it. Hope this video helped. Hope you were able to make your own tracks now. And I hope it's good. Goodbye.